Okay, good morning students.
Good
as
morning.
You all know, good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, so as you all know, we are going to play a game called Carousel Activity, which will be based on the chapter The Ailing Planet, The Green Movement Rule. Since the chapter was already initiated by all of you yesterday, and we know that this chapter is basically an anecdote, or you can say an excerpt from the paper which was published by Nani Palkhivala, but he wrote it many years back, yes, and he talked about environmental degradation and why our planet Earth is considered to be alien. So today we will be playing a game called Carousel Activity, in which you will have one-to-one discussion, and let me just explain you the game. You will be talking to the partner sitting in front of you for 2 minutes, say 40 to 50 seconds, and then I'll clap. And on my clap, the children who are sitting in this row, they will be moving. Yes? So the children who are sitting here, they'll remain stationary. And those who are sitting here, they'll be moving to the next seat and discuss the same about the chapter with the person sitting in front of you. Is the game clear to you?
Yes.
Shall we start the activity?
Yes.
Alright. So when I say 1, 2 and 3, you start discussing the content of the chapter with your partner sitting in front of you. 1, 2, 3, start.
Thank you.
Okay, so we have completed one round of the game. Hope you enjoy it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay, now you are going to tell me which two things you found common while discussing with everyone and how was your experience. Yes, Daita.
Ma'am, the first thing which I found common was the zoo at Zambia. Zambia, which was having a mirror and which was written the most dangerous animals on the earth. Where we see our own replica in the mirror, and which used to say that we are the only root cause for deteriorating this world, and not only the world, but also to the planet, to the human beings and to the other organisms. And the second thing I found common was the Green Revolution, where it started in New Zealand at the year 1972. And other thing also I found common was the sustainable development, which also said that we need to develop our country by not harming our future generations.
Very good. Okay, yes, Ayash, you were also doing something.
Ma'am, the most common thing I found in everyone's discussion was the date at which the main movement was started. It was 1972 in New Zealand. And then all have mentioned about the comparison of Earth with the living organisms, that about how the writer has compared the Earth with the living organisms, that about metabolism, about the breathing and all.
Okay, yes,
sir.
Discussion that everybody was talking about forest depletion and how the forest depletion has been affecting our earth and
thank you. Anybody else would like to share a point? Yes, Nishika.
One thing that was common in everyone's sentiments was that we have borrowed this earth from our future generations, and we need to not have the mindset that we have inherited this earth and we have the supreme authority over all its resources. We have to complete our need but not our need.
Very good. So what we have understood now by what I have gathered from what you had discussed, four points. One, that we have not inherited this earth from our forefathers. Okay, so that means we are not going to be here as dictators. Instead, we have to be working like stewards. Yes, we have to work like trustees. We have been given something to look after, to take care, and as she mentioned, that we have to use sustainable development. That means we have to use it to our limit and also save it for a future generation. Why? Because we have borrowed it from our future generation. We need to think about our own kids. When I talk about future generation, you think, okay, some other people come. But when, just imagine, I'm talking about your own children. Just imagine when you will have your children after 10 years or 15 years or maximum 20 years, what are you going to give them? Are you going to give them pure air? Are you going to give them clean water to drink? So what are all the things that we are leaving for them? So there is a very big question mark of this. And when I was discussing the point with Tushar during the discussion, there were two points that came up with. One, that they said that whatever is already issued in the newspaper, that is 7 or 8 times less than what actually is depleted. So we can understand the gap. And what they were saying in the article by Nani Palkiwala, he said that in the year 2000, we are going to face a lot of problems. And we were just discussing that we are already in the year 2021. So 21 years have already been passed. Just imagine how much depletion would have happened. And plus, whatever is mentioned on the records, government records, that's not equivalent to what is actually happening. So you can understand what is the dire need now to actually look into this environmental degradation before it gets very late, isn't it? We should not be very late, so we need to take an action. And why this particular article has been included for you people, prescribed for you, why? Because you are grown up now. You are going to take the future roles. No, maybe within a year or two, once you will be out of the school, you are going to take very responsible position in society. So when you have the knowledge, when you have this thing in your mind, you will be taking the right decision, which will be not only good for you, for society, but for our own country and the whole world. Because that's what was, you know, realized by the people in 1972, when all the representatives of different countries, they came together in New Zealand and they decided, they made a kind of forum, they made a kind of committee, where the people decided that Earth is to be taken as an individual entity, a breathing entity, which has its own metabolic needs, as he mentioned. So we should not take it for granted. granted and we should not show our dominance over this earth and keep on poking our nose in between the ecological system to disturb it. We have no right to do it. Just because we have been blessed with rain and we use it against all the life on earth, no, that's not the way, and that's what we have seen in the last 2 years or with the arrival of COVID-19. That was the kind of, you can say, the repercussion that we had to face, that the earth is taking revenge, you know, because it has been bearing so much, but now it is the height. So we must understand this, and rather than, you know, understanding it the way we explain, it's better you have different techniques, different activities through which you learn different ways, isn't it? So I hope you enjoyed. Okay, we'll continue with some other activity in the next class. Thank you very much.
Thank you.